Better than starving, I think. That's a soldier. Wow. I can't tell the difference from here.
Additional flavor scheme available.
Crossing. Choke it down, Pete. Feel a little less squishy now. The nose, a nose. Need to boil it. Spy. New one for the bestiary. Keep you safe? Safer. Lob's ghost! Spy. Worse than my mom's Brussels sprouts. Disturb the mites and they'll bite. It's no grub. It's a larva. Mark that one off the list. Water filtration tablets needed.
The Kinder Science lab modules have not held up as well as anticipated. I thought hiding these lab units in the hedge would provide a bit of protection from my rampaging children. But But it appears not even the sanctuary of these leaves can protect my work from an errant flingman disc. The subsequent breaches in the lab structures have invited all... manner of arachnid invaders to wander in. My plan is to recalibrate the tasty bots for defensive action. A stopgap solution, to be sure, but I've no time for repairs, not when I'm so close to unlocking the mysteries of raw science.
I spy... got one!
Superior to the market.
Surveyor connection established. Use survey stations to scan for analyzed materials. Visit additional stations to expand the survey network.
Where there's one Spiderling, there's bound to be more of them.
By the spiders of the yard. Climbing, crawling, skittering with the greatest of ease. Oh, and how they delight in violating my workspace. I can't take a single step without getting stuck in their confounded webbing. I'm wasting daylight, running, climbing, surviving, traversing this broken lab, the entire yard, for that matter, has become untenable. But perhaps my spider friends hold the key to my problems.
When you're off to the beach, or a day at the park, doesn't matter the time, 'cause it glows in the dark. You can leave your toys home, except for just one, because you can't leave your flingman. Never leave your flingman.
To perfecting the spacer. Raw science containment has been a success. At last measurement, we are within 0.2% translation accuracy, but those final infinitesimal bits have proven the most difficult. Despite that, Virgil and I have been able to transit the miniature world without incident. I must admit it has been a bit overwhelming of late. Between school, grading papers, nightly work in the yard, and this sweltering summer heat, I feel stretched thin. Some nights I find myself too exhausted to work on my experiments. All this is going to give me gray hairs. I mean, why, just the other day, Trudy said that the stress is putting new wrinkles on my face. She may have a point about the hair, though. As much as I'm loath to admit it, it does seem to be thinning. Perhaps it's time to dig out the Sketty clamp and try it on myself. I'm sure it's in a bin or box around here somewhere. Today, Trudy asked, or rather insisted, I take a break from my work for a family day. I'll admit, the argument that preceded my reluctant agreement was one for the ages. She just doesn't understand how important the work is. But in the end, all was not lost. As fate would have it, our little trip to Stormin' Beach's Wave Park has given me fresh inspiration. A particular attraction sported a zipline over an undulating pool filled with sun-baked tubers, basking in the light of the cruel sun that baked them like red, red raisins. But I digress. It was the zipline that captured my imagination. Such an elegant solution to my problems in the hedge. When we got home, it was straight back to work. After another argument, of course. To say the least. something without gums would suggest that. This is not some trifle to pick parsley between trips to the periodontist.
I will take your word for it, Dr. Tully.
Where there's spiderling, there's spiderlings. I'm flying!
Science!
A scientific breakthrough.
Science.
Likely that this will be my last log from the Hedge Lab. Regrettably, the spider infestation is only worsened. Last night, I had a close encounter with a giant brood mother that shook me to my core. Couple that with the strange radio signals I've been receiving, and I no longer think this facility is safe. Scanners and passcodes are encrypted in the mainframe.
Is that really necessary, sir?
Yes. Oh, yes. Absolutely necessary. We're being watched. Isolated the source of the particle irregularities. They appear to be a byproduct of the shrinking process. If I adjust the machine to account for their existence, it should be the key to the de-shrinking, expanding process. Virgil, please bring up the readings for the irregular covalent SNPI-42Z particle traces. Ugh, that name is going to get tiresome. And while you're at it, rename all references to the irregular covalent SNPI-42Z particle to Raw Science.
Order received. Raw Science identified. Does it require cooking, flipping, or grilling?
No, none of those. Categorization.
Hello there! Hit processed.
That answer is not permitted, according to health code standards governing the handling of raw food items.
Keep that aphid as a pet.
Science!
Brussels sprouts. Disturb the mites, and they'll bite.